Acesulfame potassium is an artificial non-caloric sweetener with a quickly perceptible sweet taste. It is 200 times sweeter than table sugar. It has excellent stability at high temperatures and good solubility. At first, Acesulfame K was only approved for use in chewing gum, jellies, and baked goods. Then in 1998, the FDA approved Acesulfame K for use in liquid soft drinks, and approval for general use was granted in 2003. The acceptable daily intake for Acesulfame K is 15 mg per kilo of body weight per day. Acesulfame K safety studies are fewer and of poor quality. Two studies on rats have shown that the sweetener can cause cancer. A large French study examined the effects of consuming artificial sweeteners on cancer risk in more than 100,000 people. In this large cohort study, artificial sweeteners, especially aspartame and Acesulfame K, which are used in many food and beverage brands worldwide, were associated with increased cancer risk. In a previous video about sucralose, I talked about a study in which this sweetener affected the microbial composition in the gastrointestinal tract. In a study on mice, Acesulfame K disrupted the gut microbiome after 4 weeks of use and led to an increase in body weight. Interestingly, this effect was pronounced in male but not in female mice. Acesulfame K is excreted unchanged by the kidneys. One of the byproducts of the breakdown of Acesulfame K in the body is acetoacetamide, which is toxic in high doses. When breastfeeding women consume products containing Acesulfame K, this sweetener has been found in breast milk. The FDA approved Acesulfame K despite inadequate and poor quality toxicity tests. Although Acesulfame K was nominated twice for testing in 1996 and in 2006 by the National Toxicology Program, the petition was denied and the product was not tested. Unfortunately.